All right, hello everyone and welcome back to Kotobo Space Program, where today we are having a look at the Solus Planet Pack mod, which is being made by form user Jacob JHC. And what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is a lovely new gas giant into our solar system here, as well as a few moons, all of which is sort of based on a mix between the planet J1407b and Saturn. So let's jump right on into the tracking station and have a look at what we do get, and it is quite impressive. If we zoom all the way out here, you can see that my probe is on the outskirts of our solar system there, where we'll find Solus. And if we zoom in, not only can you see that the orbit of Solus itself is quite irregular for our solar system, which makes for a good challenge, but also the moons within are even more irregular, and that is wonderful. And you may also notice a giant freaking ring. Now, you guys know me, I'm a sucker for a ringed planet, and this is a bit extreme, but still, I love it. Now, all in all, we have one planet and then three moons to go for, so let's talk about the first one that we have here, which is, of course, Solus itself. And it is quite a large planet with a radius of 12,000 kilometers, with a gravity of 1.6 Gs, and is, of course, or rather does have an atmosphere, but being a gas giant, you don't want to land on it. And again, just the massive ring this thing has is amazing. I really, really do like this. Now let's move on to the first of its moons, which is a Double. Quite a small little icy moon, very beautiful overall in its texturing and modeling, and of course flying through this one part of the ring here quite nicely, sort of above the ring as you can see there. And as for the stats on this thing, it's a fairly small moon at only 114 kilometers in size, with a gravity of 0.19 Gs, and has no atmosphere to speak of, but a part of the sort of details of this world is it does have underground oceans, or under ice, rather, oceans, with ice occasionally blasting through the surface in little geysers. It's pretty cool. If you look pretty closely at the planet here, you may see them starting to pop out, which is awesome. I really do like that little addition. Now let's move on over to the next of the moons that we do have, and that is Durus, a much, much smaller moon, as you can see here. Pretty elongated, kind of potato-ish shaped, and sort of sitting below the ring. And the idea for this one is that it has been collecting up the debris of the ring around it and gaining in mass. And it is still quite small though, at 18 kilometers in size, with a gravity of 0.066 Gs, and of course no atmosphere to speak of, but a fun little rock and quite a challenging little one though, with some odd little nubbins on the top and bottom, as you can see there. And finally, the last moon that we have, and what is meant to be a captured asteroid, is Durin. And this one is, well, equally small at 7 kilometers in size, and having a gravity of 0.033 Gs, once again, no atmosphere to speak of. But what really makes this thing special, besides its, well, kind of a cool little asteroid, and its a very irregular orbit if we zoom out here again, is its view. With this amazing orbit going basically over and under the planet of Solus here, you get just some gorgeous views of the entire ring, as well as Solus itself and its other two moons of Dulles and Double. And all in all, it's just a cool little place to visit. So let's actually take a look at my survey satellite that I have in orbit, so you can see again that gorgeous view from this thing. And if we just sort of zoom out a bit, turn off our UI, there we go. The beauty of Durin with its amazing view. We're kind of in nighttime at the moment here. I mean, well, also we're really, really far away from the sun. But yeah, just an absolutely gorgeous view from this little rock, and I think very much worth a visit. The whole pack is great. Solus itself is amazing. I always like new gas giants being added in, and especially ones with rings, and this just epically sized ring makes me happy. Dobble is a pretty cool little ice moon that would make for some fun trips to visit its surface, especially with those ice geysers. Dulness, I'm a little bit torn on that one, especially with the weird nubbins, but all in all, a very cool pack. So if you'd like to have a look at this one for yourself, which I would certainly recommend you go and do, you can have a look at the link in the description, as per usual. But that, my friends, is going to be it for today. I hope you all have enjoyed and that you do come back for the next, but until that time, thank you for watching, and as always, have a good one!